Well, yeah, of course I can see you, or am I missing something?
I am Gabrielle, an angel vanguard of the Kingdom of Haven.
Okay, you do look like an angel, but all that other stuff is kinda...
Have you witnessed other angels, human?
Huh? Oh no, that's kind of an expression.
Let me prove to you my celestial origins.
Yep, the doctor told me to expect this.
What are you implying?
I'm just gonna go over there and curl up into a fetal position until this hallucination is over. I'm gonna close my eyes and count down from 10 like the doctor always tells me to do, and you should disappear. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It didn't work! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is no hallucination, human. Get up at once.
Nope. It's a hallucination.
If this is a hallucination, then ask me questions, and I shall reply with answers that your incapacitated brain could have never even imagined.
Alright. Why are you here? Did you fall?
Yes. I did take the plunge to Earth.
Oh. Did you do something bad?
Do something bad? Do something bad?! Never. It is all Demetrius's fault. He pushed me through the 13th gate, and for that I will force him to pay for his crimes.
Whoa, easy there. Wasn't accusing you of anything, I just kinda assumed. Tyler?
Dude, you really need to stop forgetting to close the door, cause yesterday I woke up next to a giant spider! But anyway, what's up, man?
Nothing. Just having another hallucination.
Oh, another hallucination? Oh no, what's it this time? A scary monster?
Actually, she's an angel.
Angel? Did you try a pickup line on her?
Pickup line?
Yeah, like, did you ask if it hurt when she fell from heaven?
Yeah, I did, but she didn't respond well to that.
Never heard that one before. What's her name?
I think it was Gabby.
Human, I am known only as Gabrielle, a vanguard-
Hey, I have a name. It's Mark. Until you stop calling me human, I'll keep calling you Gabby.
So, ask her what Evan's like.
Haven. I need to get back there, but I don't know how!
Paranormal activity!
Hey, don't go throwing everything around in a fit. Oh my gosh. That just happened.
What was that?
That was Gabby. Tyler, I think she's real.
Wait, so like a real angel?
I think so.
She pretty?
Tyler!
What? I'm just curious.
I'd answer, but I think Miss Celestia here would have my liver for lunch.
Nonsense. Angels do not require physical sustenance as you humans do.
What's she saying?
I think she's given me some etiquette on angelic table manners.
Angels feed off of positive energies. Demons the opposite. Energy is never destroyed, it is just converted.
She said, energy is never destroyed, it's just converted. And that angels eat, happiness.
Yes, I guess that is a simple way of interpreting it for such a flawed brain as your own.
So, well, I feel sad when you get hungry.
It's less of the physical satisfaction from a full stomach and more like the presence of certain energies making us celestial beings feel, well... energized. Haven has its own private supply from the very aura of the place, and vice versa for the underworld.
Yeah. So I'm sort of third wheeling this conversation. Oh, wait. Ask what she thinks of me.
I probably shouldn't repeat that.
Okay. Well, just tell me what she told you, you know? About why she's here and all that mumbo jumbo.
This might take a while.
Huh? Where am I? Where is everybody?
Hello, fledgling. We are the Council of Truth, and you are in Haven. Do not be afraid. You are among friends.
Do you remember anything?
Yes, of course. I remember... I don't remember.
That is perfectly normal. With a new life, we shall also grant you a new name. Would you like to be called Demetrius?
I guess I'll take on the name.
That is good. From now on, you shall be known as Demetrius, a fledgling of the realm of Haven. That is Soroth. He is the keeper of the 13th gate. He will be your mentor, your guide, and most importantly, he will be your friend and ally.
Hello, Demetrius. From now on, Haven will be your home. During your training under my mentorship, I shall teach you all I can, in hopes that you will become a beacon of hope and goodwill for the humans that we guard, and for the angels that you will one day take under your wing.
I'm sorry, Soroth, but I know I did the right thing. Everything in my mind is out of place. Bethor, Adonis, Daedalus. They weren't supposed to be there. They weren't there. It was... No. I can't be forgetting them too. Just because they're dead doesn't mean I have to be forced to forget them and just move on with my life like they were never a part of it.
Still don't even know who took over as the leader of the underworld after Behemoth got killed.
Whoever rules the underworld now has been keeping a low profile.
Bethor, hadn't you just gotten promoted to my rank when Behemoth launched his assault on the 13th gate?
Yes. I held the third seat on the council when that battle took place. Probably the worst attack on our borders that we've ever experienced.
I assume that the former first and second seat were killed in combat.
Not exactly. The second seat got killed by Behemoth's minions in the onslaught. The first, well, you can guess what happened to him after the battle.
It is unavoidable for us when we reach enough seniority to take up these ranks of the highest tier.
I fear the day that it will start happening to me is quickly approaching, but for now, I shall enjoy my naive bliss.
Bethor.
Yes?
Do you think that's what happened to Soroth?
Unlikely, but a possibility. He was the 13th keeper in charge of that gate. And if I was just recently promoted as the third keeper, and the newest addition to the council, there was only a slim chance that he was affected. However, it is wise to consider that it could have been a combination of that, and a will to uphold his oath that drove him to sacrifice himself during the assault. Without Soroth, we could not have won.
Yes, I will. However, I do not see the point in... Very well. I will assume that you want me to carry out the same methods that were used for the last one. Then I look forward to it.